does all that he can to fulfill it. My docket is filled with boys and adult males who are fathers and who don't know what it takes to be a man, to take care of their business as fathers. They're lost in transition. From boys to men as a result, our kids are suffering. Our community is suffering. This irresponsibility is a major contributing factor to single mothers raising young boys on their own. Some do well because they're strong women, as was my mother. But many cannot bear the heavy burden, and our boys are becoming statistics every day. Amen. We need to show these boys and so-called men what it takes to be a real man. It takes confidence, and it takes integrity. So don't get upset when someone calls you a deadbeat. If the shoe fits, wear it. Because if you are not providing money to help feed your child, then you are a deadbeat. If you are not contributing to the clothing, shelter, and care of your child, then you are a deadbeat. If you are not spending quality time with your son to show him what it takes to be a man, and the quality time with your daughter to show her how a man should treat her, then you're a deadbeat. If you are a do-nothing father, not manning up to your responsibilities as a man, then you are a deadbeat. The message to our boys who have fathers missing in action is that it is the acceptable and usual norm. For too often, many of them are growing up to be the deadbeat fathers like the father they hardly knew. It's sad commentary on the state of affairs in our community, but unfortunately, it's true. Although the pursuit of fathers who refuse to support their child dominates my child support docket, I'm happy to report that there is a rising increase of fathers coming forward to demand their rights to be a part of their child's life. And they're not running. They're not running from their child support obligations. They're running to their support obligations. They are doing what a man ought to do. And I'm happy to encourage them to be a part of the process. I'm happy to see the confidence and integrity they display in manning up to their responsibilities. A real man has within him not only confidence and integrity, but he complements these characteristics with the courage to do what's right, no matter what the circumstances are, and no matter how unpopular the decision may be. A real man has the courage to face fear head on, having confidence in himself to control fear rather than allow fear to control him. At a past breakfast celebrating Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., the speaker spoke of when we were colored. Some of you may have been there. And he went through our transition from colored folk to black folk and finally to African American folk. He spoke about how we had more confidence as a black race when we were colored, how we were more family oriented when we were colored, and how courageous we were when we were colored. Somehow, during our transition and assimilation into the mainstream of society, we lost what we had when we were colored. There was a time when black men stood up and were courageous enough to spark movements that would change the course of history. Movements that were unpopular to some, but movements which were about making right the wrong that our people had suffered. Yes, when we were colored, we had men who had courage and who faced fear head on, and they did not allow fear to control them. When we had courageous men, we saw courageous women. And when we had courageous women, we saw courageous children. When we had courageous men and women, we saw courageous families. I thank God for the time when we were colored. It was the courage of that generation that allows me, as an offspring to take advantage of the great opportunities which have since emerged. Without their courage and commitment, it would have been difficult to enroll in a majority white college and graduate. Okay. It would have been difficult to go on to law school and finish with honors. Okay. It would have been unlikely to become a military officer. Okay. And it would have been unheard of to become an African-American circuit court judge in Montgomery, Alabama. Okay. So I honor all of those courageous men and women who had the backbone to stand up against injustice, because it is their shoulders that I stand upon today. Mm-hmm. Men today must take a page from history and learn what true courage means. In those days, it didn't take guns to settle our differences with the racist society. It only took peaceful, nonviolent demonstrations and strength from God above. Today, because our young boys lack courage, they are making themselves, they're arming themselves rather with guns, not against a racist society, but against themselves. Because they lack courage, they are tearing down with gun violence what it took decades to build with nonviolence. A real man can settle his differences with another man without a gun. Amen. Because he has confidence, integrity, and courage that makes him a man. Okay. Today, there is this thing called swag. You may have heard it, or swagger. And it simply means a display of conceited and arrogant behavior. It is behavior which tells others to look at me, I'm a big deal. If you are a young boy and you don't have swag, then you don't have it going on. You are not cool. That is the perception. That is how our young boys present themselves today. The sagging pants, the Air Jordans, the gold chains, the tattoos, the earrings, the 20-inch rims, the nice car with the booming sound system all represent the swag that our young boys and young adults emulate. They see it in the celebrity role models, the rappers, television stars, and athletes, and they believe it must be right to have swag. These same young boys grow up to become mature adults, stuck in the same mindset. Right. Only now they're just trying to keep up with the Joneses. But a real man doesn't have to have swag. He already has confidence in himself. A real man has humility. He doesn't have to always be seen. He doesn't need to be the drum major and doesn't suffer from what Dr. Martin Luther King called the drum major instinct to be out front all the time. A real man is humble enough to allow someone else's light to shine, though he powers the light. He doesn't need swag because his work speaks for him. If our young boys were less interested in swag and about being a big deal, they would be less offended when people don't see them as the big deal that they think they are. For a lot of the violence we are seeing in our community stems from this element of perceived disrespect among our young people. It takes a real man to be humble and to show humility, because our nature tells us we ought to be recognized when we do well. We ought to receive a pat on the back, and we don't get it, that acknowledgement, we tend to go ahead and we pat our own selves on the back. We go and brag about the good things that we have done. But truly, a real man can humble himself and put aside his swag. A real man realizes that in due time, he will receive the acknowledgement that he is due.